Hello friends, here in this video, we will see what is meant by a factor of safety with its complete explanation. So let us get started. Factor of safety. I'll write the definition of this. It is defined as the ratio of maximum stress to the permissible or working stress. So this is the definition of factor of safety, that it is defined as the ratio of maximum stress to the permissible or working stress. So therefore, factor of safety, it is denoted by FOS. Now it is equal to, see, we have two different formulas. Factor of safety, if I write for ductile materials, then the maximum stress in case of ductile materials, it is yield stress. So the formula is factor of safety is equal to yield stress upon permissible, or I can say working stress. This which I have written, this formula of factor of safety, it is for ductile materials. Next, I can write the formula for brittle material also. So FOS is equal to, for brittle materials, the maximum stress is ultimate stress upon working stress. This formula is for brittle materials. Now, after I have written factor of safety here, see, it is the meaning that factor of safety, first of all, FOS is a number which is greater than 1, always. So here we have to remember that the factor of safety for any given material, it should be greater than 1. Now what is the significance? Why do we use factor of safety? For that case, here I'll show a simple diagram. This diagram is nothing but stress strain graph. I'll draw for brittle, for ductile material, because it is easily flowing. On y-axis I have stress, which is denoted by sigma. On x-axis I have strain, which is denoted by small e. Now as we know, for ductile materials, they are easily flowing, they easily flow when the load is applied. So the behavior can be plotted on a graph in this way. Here I'll denote all the points. Now, this is 0 to A. Next, I have point B. This is point C. Point D. This is E. And finally, at F, the object is breaking. So, at F, it is called as breaking point. Now, since this is the behavior of a ductile material, and ductile material will be failing at point F, so now we can say that once the material crosses maximum stress will be at point E. Here we have sigma max. Now by looking at this graph, we can say that the moment a material reaches point E, After that, it can break anywhere. A very important conclusion from this graph, that if a ductile material reaches its maximum stress value, then after that it can break at any other point. And this maximum stress for ductile material, it is called as yield stress. So now, as design engineers, our aim should be to stop the material from reaching this maximum stress value. That is, we want the material to operate in a region where the maximum stress doesn't reach point E. So what we can do, we can use a factor of safety. Therefore, I'll give an example that I'll take FOS is equal to 3. Let the yield stress value sigma yt, that is yield stress, I am denoting it, suppose it is 300 newton per mm square, and this is the nothing but the maximum stress in the ductile material. Now, as we know factor of safety formula, I can write the formula for ductile material. It is FOS is equal to, which is the maximum stress, that is yield stress for ductile material, divided by the working stress, I'll denote it by sigma w, that is the working stress. Now from this, if I see here, I'll situate or shift this sigma w, that is working stress, onto left hand side. On right hand side, I have sigma yt, its value is 300, divided by FOS, that is 3. So working stress becomes 100 newton per mm square. Now what is the conclusion from this? See, previously if we are using sigma yt, that is yield stress, as the maximum stress for designing of the material, then what happens, that if the material reaches this value of 300, which is the maximum value, after that it can break anywhere. So our aim should be to operate the material in such a region where the stress on it is always less than 300. So now, as I have used factor of safety, I can see here my working stress is 100 newton per mm square. So I'll design the material by using 100 newton per mm square as the final, or you can say maximum stress. So now, when stress is 100, it means it has been reduced almost to 1/3 of this maximum stress. So somewhere the working stress will be in the region of, we can say this is elastic limit, or we can say this is the proportional limit. So here is sigma w, sigma working. It means the component which we are designing, it will always operate in this region from 0 to A, that is in the proportional limit region, where if we remove the load, the material will regain its original shape. It means the material behaves as an elastic member. It won't deform permanently because it is not crossing point A. So this is the advantage of factor of safety. I can say that because of FOS, that is factor of safety, the working stress on the material is reduced, and when the working stress gets reduced, working stress is that stress with the help of which we are designing the material or designing any product. So if working stress decreases, we can say that the material won't reach the yield stress value, and if it doesn't reach yield stress value, it is not going to break. So FOS prevents the failure of component. Now let us see the effect of FOS, that is factor of safety, on return materials. Here also I am drawing a diagram. On y-axis I have stress, on x there is strain denoted by E. Now brittle material, as we know the behavior, brittle materials when subjected to tensile load, they won't be flowing. For example, this is 0 to A and then at B, suddenly it will break. This is called as a breaking point. Now this is the behavior of, we can say, brittle materials. Now brittle materials, they will fail at a stress value which is called as maximum stress. In this case it is ultimate stress. So here at this point the stress is ultimate, denoted by sigma ut. So now if we are using brittle materials to design some component, then that brittle materials, they fail suddenly. That is, as we have seen in case of ductile materials, ductile materials, they are able to flow. So the physical deformation of ductile materials is visible more as compared to the brittle materials. And from ductile materials we can say that the moment it reaches maximum value, after that it can fail anywhere. So the behavior is visible to us. But in case of brittle materials, when it is subjected to load, then from outside we cannot see any difference in that material. But internally cracks are developed. And finally that cracks, they reach the surface and the material, it breaks. So that is the behavior of brittle materials. So brittle material would be breaking at ultimate stress. Now again, we would be using factor of safety. I'll say that for this example, suppose I have FOS as 4 and the ultimate stress is, here in this case, it is suppose 400 Newton per mm square. Now I want to avoid the material to reach its ultimate stress value because I know at ultimate stress it will be breaking. So what I'll do, I'll use the formula of factor of safety is equal to ultimate stress divided by the working stress. So therefore working stress I'll shift onto the left side, and here I have sigma ultimate which is 400 divided by FOS which is 4. So the working stress which we get, it is 100 Newton per mm square. Now the significance of this is that because of FOS, that is factor of safety, the ultimate stress is reduced and hence material will not fail. Like for example, if 400 is the ultimate stress value, working stress we have got as 100, it means this stress has been reduced to only a quarter, like this. So at this stage the value is of sigma working. So whatever component we design, for that the maximum value will be of sigma working, means it will operate only in this region, it won't go beyond this region. So when it is not able to cross this region and reach the ultimate stress value, we avoid the breaking of this component. So this was regarding factor of safety for ductile and brittle materials. Now I will give you all the factors on which factor of safety depends, or we can say the points. So factors on which FOS depends. So now factor of safety depends upon these points which I'll write here. First is the material, or we can say material selection. Now see, factor of safety value, it is more than one, but we have to select a particular value depending upon the type of material we have. So for material selection we should know that either the material is ductile or it is brittle. The next is type of loading. Type of loading means either the load is static or it is variable or it is a shock load, or we can say impact load, which falls suddenly. Next, it is the cost or economy. Cost or economy means as FOS increases, dimensions or size of the product, they will increase, and then as we increase the material cost, the overall cost of the design increases. So we have to take care of factor of safety and size relation. Next, we have importance of that machine part in complete machine. See, if we are designing any single part of machine, so we have to determine what is the significance of that part. Like even screw, nuts and bolts, they are part of a machine. So we have to understand what kind of loading are acting on that screw, nuts or bolts. So that is also an example where we have to analyze the importance of that machine part. In piston cylinder arrangement, piston and cylinder are considered very important. So very, we can say that huge amount of factors are considered while designing piston cylinder. Next, safety to human life. This is one of the most important considerations while deciding factor of safety. It is one of the most important points here. That safety to human life. Suppose if we are designing an aeroplane, in that case we have to use huge amount of factor of safety. At that point we cannot consider the cost factor first. We have to first go for human safety. So in such components, like when we are designing aircraft, when we are designing trains, in that case we would be considering human life as an important factor, which is very much higher than the cost of the product. So there we consider high amount of factor of safety, and we don't consider or we don't compromise on the material. And the last point here I have, that is life of component. See, we design component for some particular period, for some time or for some years. So as if we want the product to go on for a huge amount of time, it means if you want to increase the life of the product, then we have to increase the FOS value. So here are the factors on which FOS depends. In this video we have understood, we have seen the definition of factor of safety. I have explained what are the points, what in what way it is significant for ductile material, for brittle material, then the factors on which it depends. So I hope everything explained here is understood.